the President of the United States.
President Reagan to come to Decatur today to see you, the heart of America, central Illinois, that's on its way back, that has an enterprise zone, that's not afraid to say they're proud of America and they're proud of the president.
This is a very special treat. Having been a governor myself, I decided that the uniform for up here in the platform had already been determined by Jim Thompson, so I joined him. And I'm happy he made it that way, too. Well, this is a very special treat.
I've forgotten something. I was swinging a pickaxe on that job, and I wasn't swinging it to help somebody in Washington live better. I was working so our family could live a little better. We've kept taxes down so the people will be able to keep more of what they earn. And that's the way it's going to be. For the last 3 years working, people are arguing about how long the expansion will last. Well, don't worry about the gloom mongers. Inflation going down all at the same time. Now, this is creating so many jobs that our European allies are calling it right here in Decatur. The governor told you, you're trying out an idea that I'd like to see put to use nationally. Thanks to Governor Thompson and your Mayor Anderson, Decatur is one.
Shoulder there. but it's not too far from
pretty
here.
Pretty close. It's close enough.
That's right.
All right.
Thank you, sir.
Have a good stay.
Thank you. Thank you.
Summer during those years, and every summer for 2 months, he and I, Jimmy, you're out there somewhere, there he is, every summer for 2 months, Jimmy and I went to Lowell Park, and the Miami was loose, and the foot calling our
and over here,
We get $3,500 of foreign term. All that comes out of the disbursement. From this material, from this seed here, we get enough to grow three chickens. We get 2.5 gallons of ethanol, which is enough to make premium unleaded gasoline to fill all of those 225 gallons right there. We get 17 pounds of carbon dioxide, which is used to fumigate poison-free. It's a rapidly growing product used in fumigating burning fumes. Then we can get 35 pounds of corn sweetener, which is used in all of these foods. And I want you to see that we picked out a number of foods here. Half of the sweetener that is in one bushel is in these foods right here. Now the carbon dioxide is also used stimulate the growth of the lettuce and the cucumbers and the tomatoes. So all of this comes from that one bushel of corn. The material that comes out of here is worth $5.35 more than the bushel of corn is worth in the first. All of these things are sweetened with corn. Corn and sweetener. That's double dipping. I'm afraid that I'd like to explain a little bit about the economics of this. This plant represents $600 million. All the wet from there, all the they love this world. Environmental thing because of the CO2 that you use as a fuming eliminates any poison from the air. The civil defense people thank you because we are getting the earning of the distance to freedom from conversion wealth. The farmers thank you because there's a lot of extra income, and the workers thank you for the extra jobs. I want to say that in this decade, right now, those of us in this industry know
thank me that I turned around. The facts is, and for this evidence, what I've always believed in, and that is this free system, free people, and a free economy generates more wealth and distributes it more widely among our people than any other system the world has ever known. And I'm just dedicated to see that that system continues in this land of ours.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. Now we're going to show you the hydroponics where the CO2 and the heat is being used to salvage any waste that comes out of this plant and make it into fresh vegetables.
President, Mr. Ronald owes $53,000 in taxes, penalties, and interest. What do you have to say about that?
I'm not going to comment on it.
He says he sent the check. The check is in the mail.
I'm not going to comment.
You think he's done anything dishonest?
There we are.
Hello, Dwayne.
Here we are. Now this?
Oh yeah, you are. Oh, I'm here. This is Enthusiastically?
Of course. Thank you, sir.
Will ethics in government be an issue in this campaign?
Oh, yes, you do.
For our agribusiness forum. His academic. Centers around the aggressive protectionism being practiced by our foreign competitors. I am not referring to policies of third world countries designed to achieve an adequate food supply for their hungry people. Markets, burdensome surpluses, closed processing plants, and lost jobs. The obstacles to achieving free trade are many and complex, as you would, unless faced realistically. Your administration, Mr. President, has taken important steps in that direction by protecting our domestic sweetener industry from the unfair competition of heavily subsidized foreign sugar, and by standing firm against the European community's threats to limit the access of our corn gluten feeds to their markets. It is our hope, sir, that you will continue on this course. Let me assure you, Mr. President, that we share your desire. Free market, but first we must have a fair one. Neither the farmer nor agribusiness can compete with the treasuries of foreign governments. It is that our domestic farm legislation cannot unilaterally create fair global agricultural policies. World policies, the U.S. must first be prepared on a selective basis to use our economic power and comparative advantage to maintain our share of agricultural trade. Exemplary action and patience have not worked. We must face up.
Innovation can both bring economic growth, security, and human progress to people throughout the world. Let them come here to the heart and to Decatur. They'll see miracles being created from America's abundant renewable resources by the men and women of Archer Daniels Midland, A.D. Staley. It wasn't long ago that we were being told that our best days were behind us. And inflation, the record interest rates, and the energy crisis were so severe they would destroy the greatest heritage. To those plants here today, I just heard described would inspire your country to fill their hearts with pride. From corn and soybean processing and